Hi there, Kim Kunkel here from easydigitals.com, and I just wanted to answer a question that came in a couple days ago. Someone had asked me, how do you add a frame, like a 1 pixel or 2 pixel frame around a poster? And it's actually pretty simple, so I'm going to show you how to do that real quick. So I am using one of my most popular freebies, and that is creating a custom sports poster. And I have a bunch of videos, and then I actually did make a template that you could download for that. And I'll put a link to that below in case you want to mess with that. But when you start out, it's going to look like this, and it's pretty easy to add a frame. I'm going to select the background, and I'm just going to do this so that I can make sure that my frame is going to be centered. And I'm going to come up to my transform tool, and I'm going to add a couple guides right in the center here. Okay, so to make my frame, I'm going to come over to my rectangular tool. And if that's not showing, you may see one of these other ones. So you just need to click it and then select the rectangular tool. Okay, so we're going to come up to the top and select the top layer. So this will go on top of everything. And I'm just going to drag out. And it doesn't have to be perfect right away. We're just getting the basic shape there. And then, as you can see, I have my little cross here and my little square. So I'm just going to center it. And then I'm going to lower the opacity so I can see what's going on behind. So I'm going to lower this a little bit. And I'm going to zoom in. And just get this right on my word. This is just because of the way that I want to do this one. So then I'm going to bring back up the opacity, double click on this, actually double click over here so that you get the layer style up, and then you come to stroke. Now we don't want an outside stroke because then it just rounds the corners like that. So we want an inside stroke. That makes everything square. And I'm gonna make it white. So I double click here, and I'm just gonna choose white. And I'm gonna make it just a couple pixels, like 2. Then I come over to blending options, and this is where the magic happens. You just change the fill opacity to 0. And now you have your frame. But what if you want to get rid of this on the bottom? You will make a new layer, grab that layer and this rectangular layer, right click, merge layers. Now it's rasterized. So you can't change the color right now unless you add like some type of color overlay or something. You can't change it the way we made it before because it's flat now. So basically now you can just add, and get rid of this. You can add a mask. And you can either use a brush or the rectangular marquee tool to select the areas of the mask that you want to delete. And I'm going to fill this with black. So I'm going to, since my black is on top over here, I'm going to press Alt Backspace. And that fills that mask with black. Then Control D to deselect. And then I'm going to do it over here too. Edge it to the left a little bit. Alt Backspace, Control D. And if I want it to measure up perfectly, then I can come in here and work out the details right here. So I could take this and I could scooch it over just a little bit. Oh, let me get the right layer here. Push it over. And this one, that looks good, but I need to bring a little bit back. I'm gonna grab my brush tool. Make sure my white is on top, so I'm going to press X. Now white is on top. And just make that blend in there. Control 0 to look at it. Now, all I have to do is just the little tweaks. Like if I want my player on top, then I can bring this up to the top. Oops. And then I just want his foot. I'm pressing control and then it's going above. So that is how it's done, and I can just scooch everything over until I think it looks good. And there is your little pinstripe around your frame.